Good afternoon. My name is Mike Ranzenhofer. I am the chairman of the Senate Standing Committee on Corporations, Authorities, and Commissions. We are here in a new location today because we are in the middle of budget deliberation, so I thank everybody for appearing. We're joined by our ranker, Senator Squadron, and also Senator Comeroy. And I think that's it. Welcome.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay, we have four bills on today's agenda, so why don't we get started?
S-3016 by Senator Ritchie, an act in relation to authorizing the North Country Alliance Local Development Corporation to utilize interest derived from the North Country Alliance Trust Fund to cover administrative costs.
Questions, comments? Motion?
Move.
In favor?
Aye.
Okay. This will be referred to first reading then, or third reading. Okay, next bill.
S-4280 by Senator Ranzenhofer, an act to amend the public authorities law in relation to prohibiting the formation of a subsidiary of a public authority without prior permission of the legislature.
Questions, comments?
Yes, thank you. So this is my first meeting as the ranking member of this committee, so I thank you for your welcome. I look forward to working with you. I'm a long-standing member of this committee, as you are too. So there's little work more important in this state than overseeing our corporations and public authorities. This bill, I noticed, similar to one that was vetoed a decade ago. Just want to see if you've got any indication that we could actually move it toward toward passage.
Well, if you know what the governor is going to do in advance, I would hope that you would share that with us. But no, this is good legislation. We're going to advance it, and we're going to hope that the governor signs it this year.
Okay, thanks.
Okay. On the bill, we have a motion.
Motion.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? No. Okay. This matter will be referred to third reading as well.
S-4490 by Senator Hamilton, an act to amend the public authorities law in relation to enacting the New York Microgrids Act.
And as you note on the agenda, this bill will be referred to the Finance Committee. It will not be going to the third reading. Questions, comments?
Yes. Actually, my first question is related to that. I know that this bill creates this program, and microgrids, by the way, are something we should be doing a whole lot more in this state to encourage, so I thank the sponsor for the intent of the bill. Is there a appropriation attached to the bill? Is that why it's going to finance? Because I didn't see a full appropriation in here.
I don't believe there is. I don't think there's an appropriation. I think that it just felt that finance should review the bill as well.
Why?
I'm not sure I know why.
Okay. Was that flag put on by this committee or by the Finance Committee?
This was put on by the Finance Committee.
And we don't know. We don't know what inspired that.
Well, I assume generally when you create these things, there is, there is funding. Many, many bills have been enacted to create these microgrids and things like that, and normally they don't go anywhere unless there is funding attached to it.
Right.
So you can create this, but if there's no appropriation, it's not going to happen.
So this is actually why I asked the question, because I know in this, both in this committee and in the investigation committee, I don't know if you said on the investigation.
I do not.
I do. And in both this committee and that committee, historically there are many creations of different funding programs through ESDC, through others, to support all sorts of worthy causes. Absent, creates the program, but does not create the appropriation for that program. In general, I don't remember the practice being that those bills go to finance before going to the floor if they're absent an appropriation. And so really I'm just trying to get at if there's something particular about the bill that we missed in the reading, which is certainly possible, if it's a change in policy for the Corporations Committee, now that I'm the ranker for some reason, or for some other reason, or if it's just a quirk.
There are grants of up to $150,000. They are made by NYSERDA,
right,
rather than directly from the budget. But they are. But there is.
Right. I guess what I'm asking is this type of what I call an empty program? Are these going to regularly go to finance moving forward? Or?
Well, I wouldn't make that generalization. No, there's no policy of this committee that any microgrid bill will go to finance.
Great. And I do know it's sponsored by a member of the majority through the coalition, but I do sometimes worry about the process by which bills get referenced to other committees and the consistency and transparency on that. I have just one other question about the bill itself. I noticed that it creates energy insecure regions, which I think are areas of the state that have experienced increased electricity outages due to grid instability and transmission line issues. What are some actual areas of the state that would be defined? It seems like a difficult definition.
Well, I can tell you in my area, we had a couple of those in the last couple of weeks with storms.
So you all count? So Western New York counts?
Well, I think every area.
Or Northern Erie County counts, I guess.
It wasn't actually in Erie County. It was more in Batavia and Rochester.
Great. So Western New York between Rochester and
Rochester. I think every area has to be concerned with power outages.
Absolutely it does. I'm curious for these grants, which areas of the state would be eligible? Sort of, are there concrete examples? I suppose the chair's district. Although they may not have been due to grid instability and transmission line issues, they may have been from the weather.
It may have been for different reasons, but I know that Senator Hamilton has that concern, and I think many legislators have that concern.
Absolutely. So I would ask, Senator Hamilton and I both represent parts of Brooklyn. Would Brooklyn apply?
Yes. In the bill that Senator Hamilton put out, Brooklyn applies. It applies to our low-income communities. The price of energy consumption has increased, and it would provide relief for low-income residents.
Great. So would it also apply to a relatively rural area like the area around Batavia?
I'm not sure.
It depends on
income. To his district in
not quite as wealthy as Manhattan in your area, but they do have needs.
Brooklyn and Manhattan. Okay, I worry about that definition. I actually really do think the bill's important. I think microgrids are important. I think the point about doing everything we can to lower electricity costs, especially for those who can least afford it, is important. I'm going to vote without rec because the definition strikes me as a little bit, to quote the finance, the deputy leader of the majority, a little bit of a Hunger Games situation, and one without even closed definitions on the rules. So I would urge the sponsor, maybe you can go back to sponsor, to really tighten up that definition, because it's certainly a good bill with a good... good reason behind it, but I think without a good definition of what we're talking about, you don't want to create fights between Batavia and Brooklyn. You want to create consonants between Batavia and Brooklyn.
Well, I know the governor always likes to talk about competition, and competition is good, but I also might suggest you have that conversation with Senator Hamilton about tightening up his language. I think the bill as it is fine, but certainly it doesn't mean that a bill can't be improved, so if you want to have that conversation with Senator Hamilton as the bill sponsor, I would encourage you to do that.
I will. Okay. I will, and I guess we'll get another bite at the apple in finance.
Yes. Any objection to the bill? I know you're without Rec Center Squadron. Okay. This bill will be referred to finance, and then our last bill for today.
S-5183 by Senator Ranzenhofer, an act to amend the Nonprofit Revitalization Act of 2013 in relation to making certain provisions permanent relating to filing financial reports by certain registered charitable organizations.
Questions, comments?
Just very briefly, I do want to say this was a very important piece of legislation when it first passed. A lot of concerns attached to it.
Still is.
And you know, is really working in many ways to fix it up is important. So I want to commend the sponsor for the original legislation and for continuing to tweak it where necessary.
Okay. I'll take that as a motion.
I will go make a motion.
Okay. And all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, this matter will be approved and referred to third reading. Okay. I want to thank all the members for coming today. And that concludes today's meeting. Okay, then.